great, you know, to make it excitement. I feel as a champion, you gotta be excited and existent inside the ring just as well outside the ring as well too. My perfect idol that I look towards that made the division what it was, excitement with the heavyweights, was the one and great Muhammad Ali, because he was active inside the ring and he was just as active outside the ring with the people and stuff. And that's how I look as myself to one day be Muhammad Ali Jr.
What are you wishing for his birthday? It's coming up.
I know, man. You know, the great thing about it is that I fall on his birthday this time around. This time is a day short. But, you know, he's my idol. He's one of my all-time favorite. And I'm always wishing him well. You know, he's done a lot of things for boxing, the state of boxing, and things that will never be forgotten. When you look at a heavyweight champion of the world, Muhammad Ali. Yeah, when you say heavyweight champion of the world, meaning that he fought all that. He fought everybody. He traveled as well, too, because it says other world. I don't believe it just fight here in my country. I'm looking forward to expanding outside of my country as well, defending my title. You know, that's future plannings as well, too.
A lot of fighters have aspired to that. What makes you feel that you're the one who can do that?
You know, when I speak, I think it's different from other fighters. I think other fighters just speak off of, just to speak, the cameras in their face and the excitement. But when I speak from the heart. And my heart is warm. When I feel it inside of me. So when I speak, that's what I mean. And anything I've said, I've promised to people, I haven't failed no one. And people, like I said before, people that knows me, knew me growing up. Look, I got me a shout out. But anybody that knows me, even growing up, know that if Deontay said he's going to do something, he's going
to
do it.
But you came to the sport late, you said.
Correct.
So is it that emotion that you think that's driven you to this point?
Not really. I just think the struggles and having my daughter born with a disorder, what really motivated me. Now I added three more on to that, and now it's even more determination, even more motivation, because when those guys look up to me, you know, it makes me feel good when I go home and see those smiling faces and they grab me, daddy, and they understand what daddy's job is. But, you know, even my oldest daughter said she prayed for me that I don't get hurt or that I don't get knocked out and stuff like that. That's just her understanding of what the sport is and how dangerous it is. She more advanced than some of these people that sit on the outside that criticize, don't even understand it, you know. And it's amazing to me to see her say and do certain things. So as a fighter, it gives me all the motivation I need to go in and handle business, to come whatever night of the fight.
And you know how dangerous this sport is. You saw, you know, you got emotional with him yesterday. You know, you said you're not taking him lightly, but, you know, he's not well known. Why are you taking the risk, you know, against this guy?
Well, he was ranked enough, so we can have those that don't know you, you must be ranked at least in the top 12 to be able to fight for a title, period. And for two, you know, he was, like I said, he's determined. He wanted to become the first Polish heavyweight champion of the world.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Sekback. And you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekback. Just step back.